Heat Above is the third advanced single from Greta Van Fleet's upcoming album, The Battle at Garden's Gate, produced by Greg Kurstin, who also produced the recent Medicine at Midnight by the Foo Fighters. This album is releasing on April 16th. Hello, this is TJR with my review on this new advanced track. As always, if you like what I'm doing, be sure to click like, click subscribe, and smash the bell notification icon so you can know when I release new videos. I also want to thank my patron supporters who are helping me to make more videos. If you'd like to become a patron supporter, please go to patreon.com/TJRtheOriginal. Okay, let's get to it. Heat Above opens with an evocative, classically influenced organ solo. The more skeptical might compare it to the organ solo on Led Zeppelin's Your Time Is Gonna Come. But the only similarity is the fact that they both share a classical music influence and both are performed on the organ. By the way, in case this is your first time to the channel, I want to say that I am not a Greta Van Fleet hater. I enjoyed the double EP from The Fires, I enjoyed their first full-length album, Anthem of the Peaceful Army, and the two advanced tracks, My Way Soon and Age of Machine. But sadly, this new track, Heat Above, is the one that I find the least impressive of the three. Heat Above opens with a Hammond electric organ solo that foreshadows a more serious, darker piece of music before moving into what Rolling Stone magazine described as a sun-drenched stomp. And I feel that their description is accurate for this particular song, even if its intentions didn't exactly work for me. I could tell what this was trying to do. Heat Above is trying to be the sunlight bursting through the darkness that is the organ solo, and yet it wasn't that for me. All the proper elements for the type of song that it's trying to be are there. Acoustic guitars blended with clean electric guitars, an ascending chord progression, the joyous church organ. There are some interesting vocal textures during the pre-chorus that leads into a very triumphant chorus, and yet there was something missing for me. I don't think it's a bad song. It's just not sparking a fire in the same way that the two previous advanced tracks did. However, I do wonder if my opinion might change after I hear it in context with the rest of the album. That is what happened with You're the Best Thing About Me from Songs Experienced by U2. I initially didn't like this song as an advanced single, but got to like it better within the context of the album, and especially after I heard the album on vinyl, so we'll see. But I will say that like the last release, Age of Man, I hear what feels like an effort to move a bit further from the Led Zeppelin comparisons that has provided the reason why so many music fans have fallen in love with this band, but has also provided their critics and haters the primary ammunition for scorning them. Since the release of From the Fires, I have been saying that I feel that they will eventually start moving musically away from the Led Zeppelin comparisons. Not every track on From the Fire sounded like Led Zeppelin, and the same held true for Anthem of the Peaceful Army. So it will be interesting to see if Battle at the Garden's Gate moves that needle forward. I'm still excited and hopeful to hear the new album, though. This is TJR, those are my thoughts. Let me know what you think of this new advanced track. Please leave a comment. I want to thank everybody for watching, and I hope you all stay safe and healthy.